Hello students, welcome to my channel Easy Learning with Teacher. So today we learn the unit number 1, that is advanced Java in your advanced Java programming. So the name of unit number 1 is Abstract Windowing Toolkit, and this unit is for 12 marks, and the course score for this, that is 22517. Let's see the introduction of the AWT. Before going to start what is exactly AWT, first we learn what is GUI, the graphical user interface. Okay, so first we learn what is user interface. So user interface is the medium of interaction between the user and the computer. Like for example, when you open your start your PC or start your mobile, some buttons are there, some icons are there. And that is nothing but the user interface. Okay, so in core Java we learn how to make the console based application. Console based means what? We learn we run our programs in command prompt in console, that is Java C program name dot Java. There is some menu bars are there. Suppose we want to add something, so they ask for enter first number, second enter the second number, then we type the numbers, that is 2 plus 3 is equals to 5. So this is all about the console base. So in advanced Java we create the GUI based application, and it is user friendly, it is easy to use to the particular user. So there are two APIs for creating the console based application. Basically, first one AWT, second one, that is Swing. First we learn what is AWT, that is Abstract Windowing Toolkit. So AWT is an API to develop GUI or window based application in Java. Okay, so if you want to develop some GUI or window based application, then we use the AWT, that is Advanced Window Abstract Window Toolkit. So a graphical interface or graphical user interface is built of graphical elements called as the components. So जो भी application graphical interface से मदद से आप लोग बनाते हो, in that there is some components are used, like your text box, like your buttons, some scroll bars are there, some labels are there, some text fields are there, etc. So these are the reusable GUI components. So Java AWT components are platform dependent, that is components are displayed according to the view of the operating system that you are going to use. So in Java GUI can be designed using some predefined classes, and all these classes are defined in the AWT package, that is java.awt package. So AWT has commonly used packages are first one java.awt package, second one java.awt.event package. Okay, so AWT is API to develop the GUI or window based programming. AWT is a collection of classes and the interface. AWT provides a huge set of reusable components, that is GUI component, such as text, labels, buttons, etc. And it is has commonly two packages, first one java.awt, second one java.awt.event. Next, what are the AWT classes? So there are basically 12 AWT classes we are used. First AWT event, button, label, text field, text area, then checkboxes, checkbox group, frame, window, dialog, file dialog, flow layout, border layout, and the card layout. So AWT is a heavyweight, that is its component uses the resources of the system, and it is the platform independent component. And components are displayed according to the view of your operating system. Next, basic hierarchy of the Java AWT. So first start with object. So in AWT the object is the parent class. This object is called as the parent class, and after that component class is there. So component inherit the properties of the object class, just like your inheritance. So in the component there are basically 6 components are there. So in every application or in every GUI application, we uses these components, and it is the independent component. Okay, first button are there, then label is there, then checkbox is there, then choice button is there, list are there, and the containers are there. So what is container? So container contains all this component in it. Okay, so container क्या करता है, it contains the components, all these components in it. Again, container is divided into two types, that is window and the panel component, panel container. So in window, it is like a frame. For example, if you open the calculator window, there is some closing buttons are there, and some minimize, maximize buttons are there, closing windows are there. So frame window, it is called as the frame window. Then dialog window. So in dialog window, only we see the labels and the buttons, and only closing button is there. There is no minimize, maximize option in dialog window box. Next is panel. So panel, in frame there is some space or some sections are there, and that sections is made up of the panel. Then applet. Applet is the programming. Next, first we see what is component. Okay, so at the top of AWT hierarchy, we already see that component is the class that is under the object class. So component is the abstract class that encapsulate all the attributes of the visual components and all the UI elements that are displayed on the screen and that interact with the user or subclasses of the component. So basically 6 methods that are under the component class. First one, add method. If you want to add some components on the window, then we use the add method. Again, if you want to set the size of the component, then we use the set size method, and in that we pass the parameter width and height. Third, set layout. If you want to set the layout of that particular component, then we use the set layout method. In that, layout manager and the object of layout manager class is passed. Second, set visible. Set visibility of the components, by default the visibility mode of the component is false, and we want to show that particular component onto the window, so we have to set the visibility mode is true. That so here one parameter is plus, that is boolean b, so we are going to pass true or false here. Next, void remove. If you want to remove the component from the window, then we use the remove button, and in bracket component class object. Then next, set bounds method. Set bounds method is used to set the location of the size and the size of the single component. Agar aapko पर्टिकुलर कंपोनेंट की साइज सेट करनी है और लोकेशन सेट करना है, देन वी यूज दी सेट बाउंड मेथड. इन दैट एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट, वाई कोऑर्डिनेट, विड्थ एंड हाइट आर पास्ड. सो दीज आर दी बेसिक मेथड्स ऑफ द कंपोनेंट क्लास. सेकेंड, कंटेनर क्लास. सो कंटेनर क्लास, एज आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू, कंटेनर कंटेंट्स दी ऑल द कंपोनेंट्स इन इट. सो द कंटेनर इज द कंपोनेंट इन AWT दैट कंटेन another component like the button, text field, labels, etc. So the container is a component in AWT that contains the another component of like your buttons, text fields and the labels. So the classes that extends the container class are known as the container. The classes that extend, what it extend, the container class are known as the container, such as the frame, dialog and the panel. So here is the methods of the container class. First method, if you want to set the font of the container, then we use the set font method. So here font and font class name and object name is passed. Second, void set layout. If you want to set the layout of the container, then we use the set layout method, and in bracket one parameter is there, that is layout manager class object. Next is window. So window is the container that have no borders and the menu bar. So window is the container, but it don't have the borders and the menu bars, only the square is there. You must use frame, dialog or another window for creating the window. So if you want to create some interesting window, then we use the frame, dialog or another window for creating the window. Next, that is panel. The panel is the container that does not contain the title bar and menu bar. window is a container that do not contain the borders and menu bar, and panels are also container that doesn't contain the title bars and the menu bars. It can have other components like the button and the text fields or the labels, etc. Next, what is frame? So the frame is a container that contains the title bar also and can have menu bars also, and it can have another components like the button, text fields, labels, etc. in it. So these are the methods of the frame class, frame container. First, void set title. If you want to set the title for the window, then we use the set title method and in bracket pass the title, that is string type. It sets the title for the particular frame that you want to create it. Next, set background. So set background method is used to set the background color of the frame. जो आप लोग frame create कर रहे हैं उसका background color अगर आपको change करना है, then use the set background method and in that pass the color object. Color type, color class type, object. Next, we'll see the frame class. So, a frame provides main window for the GUI application, which has title bars also, menu bars also, and the contain the display area also. Next, it is the AWT class, creates top level window with the title and the border. So there are two types of constructor, that is frame class constructor. First, frame with no parameter. So it creates the frame window that does not contain a title. Okay. Next, frame with the title. So this constructor creates the window with the specified title that you have passed in the parameter. So there are two ways for creating the class. Okay, first one, by instantiating the frame class or by creating the object of frame class, and second one, by extending the frame class. Okay, so दो ways से आप लोग frame को create कर सकते हैं. First, by instantiating the frame class, by creating the object of frame class, and second, by extending the frame class. First, we learn create the window with the help of object of the frame class. Okay, so here first import the java.awt package, then after that create the class. So here class and class name is there. Then after that we use the constructor without parameter. Okay, so constructor and the class name is same. So here frame demo same without parameter. In that we create the object of the frame class. On how to create object of frame class, class name, that is frame, object name is equals to new class name, that is frame. Then after that, suppose I want to insert the button onto the frame window, then here create the button class object, that is button B is equals to new button, and the message that you want to show or you want to see on the particular button that you want to create it, that is click me here. So after that, set bounds. It is used to set the position of this button. So here B, that is button object dot, call the set bound method, and in that pass the x coordinate of the button, y coordinate of button, height of button, and the width of button. So here button is created, and after that we have to add this button onto the frame window. So f, that is frame object dot, call the add method, and in that call pass the button class object, that is b, f dot add in bracket button class object. After that I want to set the title of the frame window. So here call the method, that is set title, with the help of frame object, that is f dot set title, and in bracket the title of the window. Then I want to set the background of the frame. So again call the set background method with the help of frame object that is f dot set background and in bracket call the color with the help of color class, that is color dot read. Then after that set size method is there. So here we set the size of frame window using the object of frame class, that is f dot set size in bracket 300 by 300. Then after that again by default the frame window visibility mode is false, then we are going to make it true using the set visible method and call that set visible method with the help of object, that is f dot set visible in bracket true. Then after that in public static void main we call this constructor with the help of creating the frame class object. So here create the object of frame demo, f is equals to new frame demo, then first call the constructor, then this is the output of this program. So let's see the demo. Here import java.awt, first learn create the instance of frame class. So here created class is class first two, then create the constructor that is first two, then create the object of frame that is frame, f is equals to new frame. Then after that I want to add the button onto the frame, so here create the object of button class, new button and click me. Then set bound method call with the help of object of button, then f dot add in bracket b f dot set size 300 by 300, f dot set layout null, then set visibility mode true, then create the object of the class that is first two is equals to f is equals to new first two. First save this in Java C bin folder. Then go to the bin folder. Then type here cmd, then java c program name that is first2.java, press enter. Then after that java space first2 that is program name, press enter. Here the frame window is created. Okay, suppose here I want to set the background of the set frame window, f dot set background in bracket color dot red. CMD Java C first2.java. Okay. Here C is capital, control S, again compile this, then Java space first two dot Java. So likewise you can add more buttons. How to add another button? Again button B1 is equals to new button, then in bracket OK. Okay, just like you can add more than one buttons, and here type F dot add method, call add method and pass that button object in it. Okay, likewise you can add the buttons onto the frame window. This is the first way to creating the frame window. First one, that is by instantiating the frame class. Second, by extending the frame class. Okay, so for extending the frame class, first import the java.awt package, then here create the class, that is class name, that is frame demo, extends the frame class, then again call the constructor, that is frame demo. In that, here no need to create the object of frame because we are already extended the frame class. So directly create the button object, that is button B is equals to new button and click me. Again B dot set bounds, say it's setting the button position. Again here directly call the add method and pass the button object in it. No need to call the add method with the help of frame object because we already extend in the frame class. Again set size, call the set size method, in that 300 by 300, height and width is pass, then set visible method true. Now frame will be visible, by default not visible, that's why here I write the true. Again public static void main, again create the object of frame demo. F is equals to new frame demo. It is automatically called this constructor and your frame window is created here. Let's see the program. So here class, first extend the frame window, again create the constructor class, or create the button class object, set bounds, set the position of that particular button, add this button onto the frame window, set the size of frame window, set layout, no by default border layout is there, then set visibility mode. Now frame will be visible. Then public static void main, create the object of class, it is called, automatically called the constructor. Now next, save this program. Then again write here cmd java c first dot java java first. So here created the frame window with the button. Okay, so today we learn what is AWT, the hierarchy of AWT, what are objects, what is components, what is containers, then how to create frame, what is frame. There is two ways for creating the frame, by instantiating the frame class, and second one by extending the frame class. Thank you for watching.